I said before, we would reconnect with all of you when we have some more case developments, and that's why we're here today. I first want to address the comments regarding Stockton having a serial killer. You know, that's what's been messaged. That's the big question that we keep being asked. By definition, these shootings are series of killings, and so we do believe we could have potential serial killer. That's how we're going to treat it as such. At this time, we don't know if it's a person or persons. As I said before, we have absolutely no evidence that connects a person or persons to any of these incidences. But we are still receiving tips, and we still will continue to review those tips, and hopefully more information will come forward. We have some video footage that we're going to show you here today. It's going to be a very short video. And when you all see the video, I want you to pay close attention to the uneven stride that this person has. Again, this person is a person of interest. Again, we have no evidence that connects this person as committing any of these crimes, but it's a person that we are interested in talking to. Also with that, we also want you to notice just how upright this person's posture is. You know, I like to think we all have a normal gait and walk about us when we walk around, but this person's posture is extremely upright and it's noticeable. That's something else that you'll be able to notice on a video once we show them. With that, as far as interconnecting these cases, we've done that through ballistics, and once you start working with ballistics, the process gets very slow. It takes a long time to confirm the information, and it takes a long time to get those official reports. But we do have ballistic evidence that are linking our cases in a company with some video footage as well. We have 7 cases linked, and I'm just gonna give some quick stats on these cases. We find that the average age of the victim is 42. We find that the sex of the victims are mostly male. We also find that the races are mostly Hispanic as well. I'm gonna talk about the days between these incidences that we believe may have a connection. Between the incident 1 and 2, there are 6 days. In between incident 2 and 3, there's 448 days, which is quite some time from when the incident 2 happened as compared to when incident 3 had occurred. Between incident 3 and 4, it was 34 days. Between incidents 4 and 5, it was 19 days. Between incidents 5 and 6, it was 22 days. And between incidents 6 and 7, it was 6 days. Of these 7, one of them occurred outside the city. It occurred in Oakland, and we've been partnering with Oakland Police Department to have tabletop discussions as far as what information we have. Another development we've had is we had the opportunity to interview our only surviving victim. The circumstances regarding this victim took place last year. This was a Black female adult. She was in her tent when she heard someone walking around her campsite. When she came out of her tent, she encountered someone holding a gun at her. There's multiple shots at her. As she tried to defend herself by advancing at the suspect, at that time the suspect lowered his or her shooting platform. She provided us a description of what she believed that person was at the time of the incident. She described that person between 5'10" and 6', wearing all dark clothing, wearing a dark COVID style mask that was concealing his face, and wearing a dark jacket as well. As she said, there's no words mentioned at all. As you heard, the reward amount keeps increasing, and I'm not surprised. I've met some incredible people in this community that are passionate about this community. I think when trauma occurs, that's when we're stronger in this community, and it shows that. I anticipate the reward to continue to increase. I think it's in excess of $100,000 right now. You know, and I want to thank everyone from the media, the community leaders. Everyone has really rolled up their sleeves and tried to provide us tips. You know, we have the tip line open. People are serious about this. A lot of people are calling in. They're emailing. Hey, how about this person? Hey, take a look at this. you know, I'm glad that we're all doing the heavy lifting together, and that's what makes Stockton great. As we continue to get more information, we're going to continue to outreach with everyone. You know, I want to thank the men and women in this police department that have not gone home. That's how serious they have been about these cases. I want to thank our law enforcement partners. You know, all of our neighboring agencies have reached out. You know, I spoke again with the sheriff today. He's given us all his resources at our disposal, including technology that they're onboarding. So everyone is in this together. We have our state and federal partners that are doing some heavy lifting with some of our video processing and other evidence that is very time consuming to get through. But we've built an all-star team of dedicated folks that have the skills, knowledge, and ability to bring a capture to this person.